department up in Mastic, and the other distribution site is the William Floyd High School. So in addition to the bus routes, folks could still get food and grab-and-go lunches at those three locations, and we're going to see how it goes. You know, we're learning like everybody else. These are uncharted waters. These are difficult times, and if we could help ease the pain and the anxiety that most people would feel about getting grab-and-go lunches for their kids, that's what we're trying to do.
That is awesome. Awesome. It all begins today, folks. Grab-and-go, school meals. You'll have breakfast, lunch available for the students. And pretty much, Bob, it's about just waiting at your regular bus stops throughout the community, right? And it'll kind of continue all throughout the weekday mornings and all through this crisis, correct?
Correct. It's the bus stops for our elementary buildings. And what I would suggest folks to do is to go to our website, the William Floyd School District website, WFSD.k12.ny.us, or just search the William Floyd School District. And on the main page, we have all the bus stops listed in order so that you can even guesstimate how long you'll be looking for the bus at the bus stop and what neighborhood you reside in. Again, it's our elementary bus routes that we've mirrored. We're scheduled to start around 10 o'clock. Each stop should take between 3 to 5 minutes, hopefully, so you can kind of guesstimate when to look for the big yellow bus coming down your neighborhood bus stop. And if you remember where you brought your kids for elementary school, it should be the same bus stop. But check the website to make sure. And if people have specific questions or specific concerns that about their child's education, they didn't get a packet, they're having problems logging in online, or they have specific concerns. I've gotten residents saying, hey, look, I'm under a self-isolation order, or maybe even be quarantined. I can't get to the food. What can I do? I strongly suggest folks to email the school district at coronavirus@wfsd.k12.ny.us. Again, that's on the website. Or call us at 631-874-1200, because in partnership with some great community groups, we are trying to address the needs and specific concerns that folks have. It's not perfect. We're not going to be able to answer every question, but we have a lot of folks who are working real hard to make sure we get food to folks, make sure kids get their learning packets, get access online to continue some level of education while we all wait here and see how this goes. And we just pray that people, you know, have a little patience, a little understanding, and practice the common sense that we've all heard. Wash your hands, social distance, don't put yourself or others at risk.
Absolutely. And just to give the folks an example, let's say you're stop number 10, ladies and gentlemen. You know, figure about a half an hour before heading to the stop. Always remember, with all this going on, as Bob just stated, you know, social distancing at each bus stop, practice that, okay? It's important. And with others who may be waiting for bus delivery there, so keep that in mind. Also, there's some pickup locations as well, Robert. They're going to be available, right? Three locations being offered until further notice. Is that correct, sir?
Correct. We have, since our closure, we had set up three distribution points in the community. The Mastic Beach Property Owners Building, our neighborhood road in Mastic Beach is one of them. In addition to Grab and Goes, I know we are getting some food in from Long Island Cares and Island Harvest a couple times during the week. They've also been great partners with our community since the closure. So sometimes we drop more food than just Grab and Goes. So the Mastic Beach Property Owner Building on Neighborhood Road, as well as the Mastic Fire Department up on Mastic Road, they've also been a great partner, along with Legislator Rudy Sunderman and Brookhaven Town Councilman Dan Panico. And then over at the William Floyd High School has also been a main distribution point. And over William Packer Middle School, there is the community food pantry that is servicing folks for other food needs. So we highly encourage folks to check that out. And again, you know, be kind. And I've gotten inquiries from folks saying, hey, I know my neighbor can't get out for their kids. Can I grab the buses, grab the meals off the buses and leave it at their front door? Absolutely. We're encouraging folks to be smart, be safe first. But if you can help out in a situation like that, doesn't put yourself or others at risk, we're not going to say, no, we can't give you grab-and-go lunches for a neighbor who can't get to the bus stop. We're trying real hard to get as much food out to those that are in need. We expect people to, again, be kind, be considerate. We don't want a situation where people are loading up a shopping cart with lunches. That's not going to happen. We don't want a toilet paper debacle on our hands. Just take what you need. If you're helping for a neighbor, that's fine. If you are somebody that is shut in at your house, again, call the hotline number, 631-874-1200. We will do our best to get your name and information to somebody that may be able to help, but I would strongly recommend, you know, talk to a neighbor on the block that you stand at the bus stop with and say, hey, maybe he can help me out, just leave it at my front door. Again, you know, this is not going to be perfect, but this is something that we're trying so that we make sure we get as much food to as many kids as possible. And we're also working real hard to make sure we continue the level of education for our kids as possible. So check the website daily for any updates. And, you know, just, again, pray that this ends sooner than later. Pray that folks get through this better than before. I think this has kind of been a good reboot for everybody. If we try to look at a positive as to what matters, family matters, material things, not so much, and getting back to the basics. So, you know, we'll get through this together. We'll come out stronger than before on the other end as well. I'm confident of that.
No question. We're going to be a resilient bunch more than ever. Bob Vecchio, president of the Board of Ed over at William Flynn. Nobody does it better. And help thy fellow neighbor. It is that type of situation, without question. You know, Bob, one more thing. You and I always remember in the past, this time of the year, you and I would be gearing up for those elections educational process and everything else. Always a lot of fun, speculation, budget, numbers, yeah. April 1st, yeah. Albany. But it's kind of, I mean, I'm just curious. It's almost a big void, right? Especially somewhat of your nature, because the concentration on that such this time of the year, but obviously other things of more importance, like what you just described. But certainly kind of an eerie feeling coming over the educational process right now, right?
Yeah, well, boards of education across New York State, I know, are still meeting and talking with each other. We've had a telephone meeting, if you will, to discuss logistics about a lot of things. We are still keeping an eye on the budget process. You know, that hasn't taken a total back burner, because we know we have to be prepared and ready to roll when the state says, okay, let's get this going. We're paying attention to the State Education Department guidance on a daily basis when it comes to things like the budget vote. I know there has been some talk about calling for the state to postpone the vote that would normally take place in May, and that's not unprecedented. When I first ran for the Board of Education in 2003, the May vote was pushed back to June because of a recession that the state was going through at that time, and the state wanted plenty of time to get state aid worked out before schools had a vote on it. So there is a precedent for that. Whether they do that or not, we'll see. What I can assure you for William Floyd, and this is probably no different than my colleague boards across Long Island, because we all care about this. This is why we're in it. We're still working together towards what will be our budget, what will we be doing come July 1st when our new fiscal year starts, and we'll be ready for a new school year in September no matter what. When you think about how the education system has so quickly adopted and adapted to the closure and what needs to be done and some of the mandates that the state has placed on schools during the closure, it's nothing short of miraculous what these school administrative teams combined with their community input have been able to do. I mean, I've been reading and seeing stories of what schools have been doing across Long Island, and I'm always a proud public school advocate and a public education advocate, and I couldn't be more proud of what our education system has been trying to do to be a focal point in communities in need, to making sure that their kids and their families and their communities get what they need.
Robert, great job. Check out the website, ladies and gentlemen, the grab and goes and the bus stops and everything else. And again, allows that extra time involved for these deliveries to take place. But nobody does it better than the William Floyd District. And of course, leading the way, our old pal, Mr. Vecchio, Robert Vecchio, Board of Ed President there. Sir, don't be a stranger. Anything you need, just hit us up, okay?
All right, same with you, Jay. Stay safe. And again, folks, just take the time out, say a little prayer, and we'll get through this. And, you know, we'll be back to normal, and, you know, what the new normal will be, we'll see. But you know what? We'll be okay.
I think so. It's acts of kindness being demonstrated in that district that will get us through these tough times. We will talk soon, my friend.
All right, Jay, be well.
You got it? The great Bob Vecchio.